All right, let's give this optimization problem a go. We have a rancher who wants to fence in an area of 300,000 square feet in a rectangular field and then divide it in half down the middle, parallel to one side. What's the shortest length of fence that the rancher can use? So whenever you get going on these, I would say draw a picture. Even if you aren't a good artist, draw a picture first. Just try to represent exactly what's going on in our given situation. So I've tried to over here draw myself a rectangular fence, and then we split it down the middle, and I chose to go vertically. We could have just as well gone left and right with another length of fence. All right, next up, what we want to do is set up one function, an objective function. That's whatever we're trying to maximize or minimize. And then we want to set up a constraint equation. That constraint equation is going to be based on some constraint, some number that's been given to us in the word problem. So in this case, our area is being constrained. We want to have 300,000 square feet for the area. Okay, so the area here has to be 300,000 square feet. And we are trying to find the shortest length of fence that this rancher can use. So I'm going to use P for perimeter, meaning that if I add up all the sides, those lengths of the fence, I want it to be the smallest possible perimeter. All right, next up, let's go and label our picture over on the left-hand side. So I'm going to use X for the label on each one of these fences, and going all the way across the top, I'm going to use Y. And that'll be the same as everything that goes all the way across the bottom because it's a rectangle. All right, next up to our constraint equation, let's go ahead and say, well, we know how to calculate the area of a rectangle is just base times height or length times width. In our case, I'm going to say that's X multiplied by Y. For our objective function, that is the perimeter. That's actually all the lengths of fences added together. So in our case, we have three X's and two Y's. And we would like to minimize this perimeter. But to do so, we kind of want to have that all in terms of one variable. So right now we have X's and Y's. What we're going to use our constraint equation for is we're going to solve that down for either X or for Y. I'm going to choose to solve it down for X, although you could just as easily solve it down for Y. So that gives us X equals 300,000 divided by Y. I'm going to take that over to our objective function, and I get 3 multiplied by 300,000 over Y plus 2Ys. Little bit of rearranging here before we take the derivative and try to find critical values. Simplifying down, I'm going to do 3 times 300,000 is 900,000. And instead of having that over Y, I'm going to write this as Y to the negative first power because it'll be easier to take the derivative if it's written as a power that way. So next up, we're going to take the derivative of P is going to be negative 900,000 Y to the negative second power plus 2. All right, from here, what we can do is we want to set this equal to 0 and solve down. This will give us our critical numbers. So 0 equals negative 900,000 Y to the negative second. And actually, instead of using the negative second, I'm going to rewrite that so it's down in the denominator, making it back to a positive exponent. So Y to the positive second plus 2. All right, to solve this down, I'm going to move the 2 to the other side. So subtract 2. So negative 900,000 over Y squared. And to solve for Y, I got to get it out of the denominator. So we'll multiply both sides by Y squared. So really this would be negative 2Y squared equals negative 900,000. We'll isolate the Y squared by dividing both sides by a negative 2. So Y squared is equal to 450,000. And to get rid of the square, we're going to apply a square root to both sides. Now we don't need to worry about the positive and negative that we normally do when applying a square root, because remember, Y is this side length of our fence. So we could leave it as an exact answer. the square root of 45,000, or if you're actually going shopping and building this fence, you may want to get an approximation. I got this to be 670.82, and that'll be in feet. I am going to use the exact answer as we finish this up and find the minimum amount of fencing and the dimensions though. All right, so we know Y is that square root of 450,000. And now we want to find a value for X. So I'm going to take that value back up to our constraint equation, and we can get a value for X by going 300,000 divided by that value for Y was the square root of 450,000 is going to be our exact X value, which works out to be approximately 447.21 feet. So the shortest length of fencing that we can use is if we plug back into our objective function and get the actual perimeter. If we, you know, that was what we set up to add together all of these lengths of fencing. So to finish this up, we'll plug it back in. We have P equals 3X, so 3 times 300,000 divided by the square root of 450,000 plus 2 times the square root of 450,000. And we could get our calculators out and get an approximation for this if we actually need to go shopping. So 900,000 divided by the square root of 450,000 plus 2 times the square root of 450,000. I got to be the total amount of fencing here is going to be approximately 2,683.28 feet. All right, hope this helps out in setting these up, solving them down. These can be challenging, but draw yourself a picture. Make sure that you always set up a constraint equation with whatever number is given to you, and make sure you're confident about whatever you're trying to either maximize or minimize, like our situation here. All right, good luck to you on them.